Hey everyone, what's going on? Listen to us. This is part three of our series on how land works, land deals works, that kind of thing. Okay. There's so much money to be made. If you can leverage land, if you're in real estate, you're a real estate wholesaler or fix and flipper or landlord, okay. Obviously those are great strategies, fix and flips. I've done that for decades. Okay. But if you understand how land works, that works in concert with, okay, your residential real estate, kind of deals, you make a lot of money. Okay. And that's the purpose of these videos. This is part three. We talked about the history of land development in the United States, why land's important. It's something that's not new. People ask me all the time, well, you want to do as lots, but does it work here? Does it work everywhere? It sounds kind of weird. No, people have been making money in land, specifically in the United States, since, Jamestown, 1607 and everything, okay? And you can watch those videos again if you want to go into that more. But I'm going to talk right now about legal descriptions, okay? What makes, allows you to know what you're buying, okay? And if you can understand how legal descriptions work in your real estate business, you can make a lot of cash, potentially, okay? So much money to be made if you understand how land works, okay? And the reason why I'm making this video is maybe you're new to real estate, or you've been doing it for a while, but you don't really pay attention to legal descriptions. You're just doing the address, trying to get a property under contract, or flipping it. Legal descriptions really are really important to understand, okay? That's why it's so important for you to have a good title person that can help you with this closing attorney, that kind of thing. So we talked, in the last couple of videos about different kinds of legal descriptions. East Coast started out using the European, specifically the British way of dividing land with metes and bounds, rods, and it's kind of meandering here and there, and about, eight rods, thence to the elk, sycamore tree, thence, 45 degrees to the brook, and then, north to, James Smith's old dwelling, random stuff. Okay. And then Jefferson, our dear president, made the public land system. He really promoted this in 1785. We started pushing this, and went in 1803 when he got the Louisiana Purchase. They sent a bunch of surveyors to survey it, and then it was on a grid. It's the rectangular land survey system or public land system, where it's you got the baseline and the meridian doing this, and townships, all that kind of thing. All right, so this is what a legal description is. Legal description, you want to take some notes here. Legal description is really important. Okay, it's the geographical description of real estate. So it identifies its precise location. This isn't just 123 Main Street or 653 Birch Street. No, this is actually deeper than that, because my buddy does a lot of ag deals. He's got legal description. He does, thousands of acres at a time. And he'll have a legal description that's 60 pages long. 60 pages, right? Thick, right? And there's no address to it. It's just here and there, okay? So legal description actually varies precisely where your property is, okay? And it talks about the boundaries, okay? And the legal description also have easements in there for, if the utility companies get in there. And some of these easements are really, really old, okay? For ingress, egress, for a carriage deal, but somebody's trying to get in there from the 1890s or something, right? Which we'll talk about in a little bit. Okay. So but the purpose of this, the legal description, is so when you transfer it, exactly what you're buying. Okay. And the surveyors will go out there, and especially new land deals, you may have to hire a surveyor to go out there and find the pins, okay, to know. So everyone's gonna know where what their lots are, okay? So a legal description also, it's important for you to know exactly what you're buying, okay? And this legal description is recorded with the deed, it's filed with the county clerk or the county assessor. And the county assessor, of course, it's important to them because they like money, okay? They wanna know They want performing assets. They're always going to be taxed on property because they love their gumma cheese. Okay, so that's the legal description is, and it's generated and prepared in the beginning by a licensed surveyor. Okay, you can't just randomly go out there and I'm going to roll up that tree and put a stake in it. There's already been a grid that's very, very, very old, particularly back east. If you're in Massachusetts or Virginia, you're talking about legal descriptions that have been there for 400 years. Okay, does that make sense? And then you subdivide. Anyways, you get my point, right? So these legal descriptions are generated by a surveyor. And so the point for you, the takeaway for you is this. You got to have a legal description in every contract you have. You know, I'm going to buy 123 Main Street from Fred Flintstone. Okay, cool. So what is 123 Main Street? It has a legal description, okay? That's essentially what the legal description is. It's a description of the plat map. We're going to talk about that, having a series on what that means, okay? Plat map, okay? So it's to describe the real property you're buying, okay? That's it. Now, whenever you, if there's a dispute on what you're actually buying, where's the property line at, you're going to have to get a surveyor involved to figure that out, okay? And how you can make money in this business, again, if you can potentially do an administrative lot split or maybe do a lot line adjustment, we'll make some other videos on those. Again, that's a really big part of these strategies. You're going to need to get a good surveyor to help you with that, okay? And they're going to do they're going to resurvey the property, and you're going to go out and go, okay, the house is here, there's all this land, we can split it right here and have another buildable place right here. Does that make sense? Okay. So a surveyor is really, you gotta have a good relationship with a good surveyor to help you do that. Okay. So these surveyors, the legal description are generated by, survey guys, licensed surveyor, and they'll accurately describe real estate for the legal transaction, the transfer, and also disputes, dispute property lines, that kind of thing. Okay. And the legal descriptions, listen, this is important. They note the precise location of the property, and they'll include sometimes geographical features such as body of water and also, easements. Okay. So, we talked about the first kind, and if you're in the East Coast, you're going to have the meets and bounds. Okay. And the stuff, later on, if you're out in the West Coast, like I'm at, you're going to be doing the rectangular survey system, the baseline for east and west, and then meridian for north and south. Okay, and they are divided into smaller sections, so on and so forth. So that's the second kind of, if you're out west, you're going to have a legal description that's going to be like that. Okay, and then the third kind of legal description you're going to see is particularly in a subdivision. Okay. It's in lots and blocks, lot 3, block 6. And they're going to be recorded again in the recorders, the county clerk's office. Okay. In the county. So just because it's in a subdivision in Oak Ridge, Oregon. Okay. Oak Ridge, Oregon happens to be in Lane County, Oregon. Okay. So it won't be recorded in Oak Ridge, or it might be somewhere, but it's going to be in Eugene, which is the county seat of Lane County, Oregon. Okay. Why am I saying Oak Ridge, Oregon? My grandparents were there. It's a cool city if you get to town. Anyway, who cares? I care. You don't care. Fine. So you get my point, right? So that's where that information is to be in. So the legal description is not based in just the town, it's the county level. Okay. And so these subdivisions are going to be named, Johnson subdivision, it was a big deal when it was recorded, the subdivision itself was recorded a long time ago, and it'll be lot and block kind of thing. So I hope that helps with what a legal description is. So the takeaway for you is every time you get a contract, you're going to have a purchase contract and an assignment contract. You got to have that legal description in there. It's going to help you know exactly what you're buying, and your buyer, if you're going to assign it, he wants to know where he's going to buy it. Okay. And if you have a larger area, larger thing, they're going to want to know where it's at and be prepared to mark the boundaries, And if you don't know where the boundaries are at, you're going to have to get a surveyor. Okay. Well, it costs money. Well, yeah, It's going to cost you some money. Okay. But you need to know that, right? You want me to lie to you? Well, it's free. No, it's not free. Right. So you need to know that. So the takeaway though is, if you know legal description, always look when you got to buy a property. Okay. Is this, sometimes you'll have two legal descriptions on the property. Okay. If you have two legal descriptions, what you're buying. Okay. I've done that so many times when I first started, two legal descriptions, didn't care. I'm just trying to make the deal, blah, blah. Just take a step back, because if you get a free legal description on there, and I mean free, can you build on that? Well, no, it's just a small easement. Okay, well, is it used anymore? I mean, is it through the power company? No, it's just, well, then see if you can do a lot line adjustment, adjust the lot lines, okay? And so that you have now a free buildable lot. Does that make sense? All right. And so also consider, can you split the lot through an administrative lot split? Administrative lot splits are awesome because they're split at the administrative level. Okay. So listen, if you have questions on this, you want some training, you want some mentorship. I mean, if you understand how lots work, legal descriptions, land works in conjunction with your real estate wholesaling, you can turn a $5,000 wholesale deal into $100,000. Okay. If you need help with this, you want some mentorship, call me right below here. Let me know, and we'll set up a time, free consultation, and we'll get you going here. Okay, talk to you soon, and Godspeed. Talk soon.